Good morning, student. In previous lecture, we have studied Brooks deflection potentiometer. Now, coming to the sixth method of DC potentiometer, that is self-balancing potentiometer. Basically, in industries, a continuous measurement of non-electrical quantities is required as to process the dynamic and the value of quantities that are continuously changing with time. To measure that variable quantities, we need some self-balancing type potentiometer. A constant attention of the operator is must in such situation when the quantities are being varied. A self-balancing potentiometer helps in continuous measurement and hence it eliminates the constant attention of the operator also. It is widely used in industries and in application to that, it is self-balancing feature, that is automatic balancing. It draws a curve of a quantity that is being measured, like for here we are having a value of voltage that has to be recorded. So it draws the curve of a quantity that is unknown with the help of recording mechanism. That curve can be displayed on the operator desk for monitoring purpose also. Now, coming to the construction and working of this self-balancing potentiometer. Here it's the block diagram representation of self-balancing potentiometer. In such potentiometer, the unbalanced EMF is applied. This unknown EMF is applied to the amplifier via converter. The output of amplifier is supplied to the control winding of the AC servo motor here. This drives the motor to move the potentiometer slider to balance here. This motor will move the potentiometer slider and it will get balanced if the condition of unknown EMF is value of this unknown EMF is known. The converter inserted between the potentiometer output, here the output will be feedback given to the converter also. So the this converter inserted between the potentiometer output and amplifier input converts the DC unbalanced voltage into the AC unbalanced voltage. So for here in this scheme, we will be using a AC amplifier because in DC amplifier it has an inherent problem of instability and a drift. So this is a basic type of self-balancing potentiometer. For illustrating this diagram in more, we'll see the next block diagram of this systematic diagram of self-balancing potentiometer. So in brief, in short, we have seen the block diagram previously. This is the actual diagram of self-balancing potentiometer. So in this diagram, we can see it the converter is also here, amplifier is there, the motor part is there, and it is connected mechanically to this potentiometer, and this unknown EMF is there. So it consists of a converter having a vibrating reed here driven synchronously from the line voltage here. So the reed operates as a switch that reverses the current through the split winding of the primary input transformer of each vibration of the reed. If there is any vibration, it will give that vibration to the input of the transformer. The constant current of each vibration cycle of the reed converts the unbalanced DC voltage that is supplied on the input side of the transformer. So unbalanced DC voltage of the potentiometer circuit into the alternating voltage at the secondary winding of the input transformer will be given to the AC amplifier. So the AC output of the converter that is proportional to the DC input of the converter is applied to the amplifier. Now the amplifier output is imposed on the control winding of two-phase induction motor. Here it is an induction motor. So the line voltage supplies the other winding of the motor. The AC line voltage is shifted by 90 degree in phase with respect to the converter output voltage by capacitor in the converter driving circuit. Now as we know that in the induction motor we have to phase split the winding to make it work or to generate the torque. So the phase of the amplifier output voltage will either lead or lag by 90 degree of line voltage applied to the induction motor. So depending upon the polarity of unbalanced voltage applied to the converter input terminals. Like I'm repeating once more, the phase of the amplifier output voltage here will be like in lead or lag by 90 degree of the line voltage applied to the induction motor. So this lead and lag will be depending upon the polarity of unbalanced, that is feedback in the converter side. Okay, so whatever will be the unbalance, in according to that the lead and lag will be provided by the amplifier. So the direction of rotation of the motor is determined by the phase relationship between the two voltages at the two windings, and in turn it is determined by the polarity of voltage supplied to the converter. Like whatever will be the unbalance, the direction of rotation of this motor will be according to that. So if the EMF being measured, there will be a two case now. So if there is a EMF, first case when the EMF is being measured is greater than the balancing voltage produced by the potentiometer here, the motor will turn in one direction. If the EMF, second case, if the EMF is being measured is smaller than the balancing voltage, then the amplifier output will be shifted to 180 degree and the motor will turn in opposite direction. Direction opposite to that of first case. Okay, the shaft of the rotor here is mechanically coupled to the slide wire contact in such a way that the rotation of motor decreases the unbalance of the potentiometer circuit. Whenever there will be a unbalance, any decrement in the unbalance of the potentiometer, the motor rotation will also be decreases, or it's vice versa. If the rotation of motor is decreases, that indicates us that the unbalance of the potentiometer is be done. So when the EMF being measured is equal to the potentiometer voltage, the amplifier output voltage is zero, and that in turn will gives us the motor does not rotate. Whenever there is a condition of balancing of potentiometer and its feedback to the converter, when there is no unbalanced feedback is given to the converter side, so at that condition the whole process will go at stop. Like converter will not proceed to the AC signal to the amplifier, and in turn the amplifier will not give the phase or lead or lag supply, voltage supply line to the line voltage. So in that case, if there is no feedback to the converter of unbalance, the motor will stop running. So at that condition we'll say that the potentiometer is being given a exact reading of unknown EMF. So under any condition of unbalance, the amplifier output will cause motor to move, the potentiometer to balance. So if there is any unbalance, automatically the Amplifier will give the output voltage to the control winding. The signal supplied to the input of the potentiometer circuit is passed through low pass filter. Here we can see there are filters applied to it. The filter capacitor have no effect on the DC voltage supplied to the input, but any rapid variation in the input signal and any stray AC signals that may be impressed upon the input signal are smoothed by the action of these capacitors we have connected. So this is basically to remove any kind of abrupt signal or abnormal signals of unbalancing to the converter. So these all are filters to just restrict the unknown signal or stray effects of the AC signal to the feedback of the converter. So the motor which moves the slide wire contact to maintain the potentiometer balance is mechanically coupled to the pan mechanism here. Any movement of the slide wire contact is followed by the simultaneous movement of the pan on a strip chart. The chart can be driven by a separate clock motor with the adjustable gear train to obtain the desired chart speed. So this is all about this self-balancing potentiometer. We have seen two types of diagram here. First, the block diagram of this self-balancing potentiometer, and the second one is systematic diagram of the self-balancing potentiometer. Here we have completed DC potentiometer. In next lecture, we'll start the AC potentiometer, where AC potentiometer having only basically generally two types of potentiometer, that is polar type potentiometer and coordinate type potentiometer. For now, I'm ending this lecture here. For any query, you can write me. Till then, continue your lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.